Yeah, definitely. We did see some rain out there today. The clouds were around and some cooler temperatures too. It felt a little bit chilly out there. We were below average and we are much cooler than where we were this time yesterday in a lot of spots, especially the further west you go, where temperatures yesterday actually did get into the 70s. But we had some cool places that did stay in the 50s yesterday afternoon, and that's generally where we were today. Highs struggled again to get out of the upper 50s. An average high for this time of year are right around 64 degrees. So we were well below that today. Even our low temperatures, though, were in the 50s, so our lows were on the milder side. Highs tomorrow as we get into Sunday will be much more seasonable. Highs do return back into those middle 60s as we head throughout the day tomorrow. And the sunshine does return a little bit as well heading through Sunday. The rain with our next system does look like it stays mainly to our south. So tomorrow is expected to be a dry day now. And again, a little bit of sunshine does return with those milder and more seasonable temperatures. Currently, we are still sitting in the 50s, 55 degrees in Allentown, 54 in Reading and Lancaster, 52 in Pottstown, reporting some of that rainfall. And we're still dealing with patchy areas of rain through this evening, 54 in Philadelphia, 53 down towards Wilmington, again, reporting rain there. And you can see that the satellite and radar showing that rain pushing its way through the area. That will continue to work through and taper off this evening. And then as we head overnight, the clouds are expected to break. So again, as we get into Sunday, some sunshine will be returning to the area. But this continues to shift its way off to the east, and we will see some drier conditions later on tonight and as we get into the day tomorrow. So here's the future satellite and radar timing everything out for us. That rain moves out of here. Later tonight, we see drier conditions. Those clouds break. And as we get into Sunday, some sunshine does return with those milder temperatures. So tomorrow does stay dry. It's a pretty pleasant second half of the weekend. If you have any outdoor plans, tomorrow is certainly going to be a little bit better for that compared to what we saw today. Then as we get into Monday, the opportunity for some rain comes back. The steadier and heavier rain does stay mainly to our south. And as we head through the early part of next week, it is going to be more unsettled. So Tuesday, we see the opportunity for rain at times again as well. And Tuesday, likely going to be another cooler day before we have a warm up in store for the second half of the week. So the second half of next week, the end of April, is going to be much more summer-like as we see temperatures surge up towards the 80s. So here's the temperature trend over the next 10 days. You can see our average high is 64 degrees. We're going to be closer to that tomorrow, so milder than today, much more seasonable. And then another cooler day as we get into the early part of next week. Tuesday, highs likely struggle to get out of those 50s again. And then the warm air moves in. Wednesday, mid-70s, and the second half of the week, temperatures are pushing into the low to mid-80s, so well above average, much more summer-like. So if you haven't been a fan of the cooler temperatures that we saw today, we do have those warmer temperatures on the way. Tonight, though, lows fall back into the upper 30s, so we're seasonably cool with that rain lingering around this evening. Then the clouds do break, so tomorrow some sunshine returns to the area. We'll be more seasonable with highs in the mid-60s. Here's the 7-day forecast. Again, a couple of showers around through the early part of next week. Tuesday, a bit breezy and cool with highs in those upper 50s. Then the warmth kicks in. Those summer-like temperatures return. Highs push into the 80s. Could see a shower or thunderstorm later on Thursday. Chandy?